Corinne Farnetti, Assistant Professor of Sport Management in the Bolt School of Business. I'm here today to discuss how professional sport franchises determine athlete salaries. These decisions are made on an annual basis, so it's important for teams to know exactly what they're getting into. There are several main contributing factors that go into this. I'm going to talk about four today, first of which being supply and demand of labor. Recently, the Baltimore Ravens re-signed star quarterback Joe Flacco to a six-year, $120 million deal. They knew they needed a quarterback, so they looked at Joe Flacco and all the other available options. It's also important to understand each athlete's characteristics. In other words, teams will send out scouts to evaluate talent, comparing athlete against another athlete. Some of the characteristics that go into this are age, number of years in the league, past performances, and medical history. Scouts then take a salary range back to management so they can make their decision. Another factor that goes into making these decisions from the management's perspective is that they need to know how much an athlete will contribute to their team's winning percentage. So when winning increases, so do ticket sales, merchandise sales, and viewership, all of which are important in bringing in revenue. Finally, teams need to stay within their league's salary restriction, whether it be a salary cap or a luxury tax, both of which are put in place to help keep a maximum on the amount of money spent on a roster in a given season. These policies help maintain competitive balance league-wide. Ultimately, salaries will continue to rise as athletes are pit against one another in the negotiating process. Management can only hope that these high-priced athletes can contribute substantially to their team's marginal revenue.